Hello all, welcome to part 16 of Python tutorial. In this session, I am going to explain about the different control flow statements in Python. So let's get started. First of all, what exactly are these control flow statements? Let me explain. Generally, when you write the Python code, when you write the Python code, let's say this is the first line of the Python code, this is second line, third line, fourth line, and so on, right? This sequence of code we have in Python. Let's say this code is written in Python. Now, when you run this code, the code will be executed in a sequential manner. That is, after first line, then the second line will get executed. Then after second line, then third line, like that, sequential manner, one by one. But coming to the control flow statements in Python, we can execute the code like this. Okay, we can jump from this line to some other this line. Okay, like this. Okay, the code will not be executed in sequential manner. In control flow statements, the code will be executed like this. Okay, after the first line, directly we may jump to the fifth line. Okay, it's possible with the help of control flow statements in Python. So hope you understood what is control flow statements in Python. Okay, there are several control flow statements in Python, so which change the execution order of the code. Okay, instead of executing in a sequential manner, the code will be executed in a different order. Okay, random order. So what are the different those control flow statements then? So here is a diagram. As you can see, the control flow statements in Python can be categorized into three categories at a high level. That is, first category is selection or decision statements. Okay, you can either call them as selection statements or you can call them as decision statements. So the examples of the selection, decision, or if else, and if, elif, else, okay? They have a condition, guys, okay? Based on the condition, a set of code will be skipped or executed, okay? Based on a condition, a set of code can be skipped or executed. I'll explain more about the selection, decision statements in the next few sessions. The next category we have the repetition or loop statements, okay? You can either call them as repetition statements or loop statements. Here, the same set of code will be executed multiple times, okay? With the help of this repetition or loop statements, the same set of code will be executed, can be executed multiple times. You don't have to write the same line, same code multiple times. Instead, write only once and execute the same code multiple times. How many times you want to execute, you can execute, okay? I'll explain more about repetition and loop statements in the upcoming sessions. And coming to the third category of the control flow statements, we have the transfer or jump statements, break, continue, return, try, and except. These keywords in Python we have to use to achieve this transfer or jump statements. Okay, I'll explain more about transfer jump statements in the upcoming sessions. Okay, so for now, at a high level, okay, the control flow statements won't be executed in a sequential manner. Okay, depending on some condition or loops or okay, jumping or whatever the nature. Okay, the flow will not be sequential. It will be random or in a different order. Okay, so these are the control flow statements in Python, guys. I'll explain one by one now. Okay, after this session, I'll explain one by one the upcoming series. So that's all about this session, guys. Thank you. Bye.